Whitney Laboratory is the perfect meeting place for ecology and technology, salt and fresh water, and now a unique blend of conservation and discovery.
I'm Todd Osborne. I'm a biogeochemist.
I'm Joe Ryan, an evolutionary biologist.
These two new advancing researchers are tackling top scientific issues daily.
Oh, hey, Todd.
And this is their office.
Going out today?
Yes, sir.
These professors, with a sense of humor intact,
it's a little bit of a long walk to the coffee pot,
are passionate about what they bring to the Whitney Lab's table.
Being a computational biologist at a marine laboratory is actually kind of weird, but it's great because in order to really ask the right questions, you need to see the animals. Right now, there's a jellyfish bloom happening as we're speaking.
And this area is very important because it gives us an opportunity to see what climate change will do to our coastal ecosystems.
The campus is located on Florida's most pristine estuary, which is a valuable research tool and an important meeting place for climate change.
We are on the ecotome between Spartina, which is the normal dominant vegetation, and salt marshes, which goes from St. Augustine all the way to Maine. But right here, right beside the lab, is actually the ecotone for mangroves, and they're new to the area. This is an example of climate change in action that we can visualize.
Together, Osborne and Ryan are capitalizing on this location to make important discoveries. One way they're doing that is the Matanzas Biodiversity Project.
It's a project designed to gather information on who's here. And when I say who, I mean the animals, the plants, all of the biota that are interacting with this environment.
We're interested not in recent evolution, what happened in the last 5 million years. We're interested in what happened 550 million years ago or 600 million years ago or maybe even more. Could we make a genomic baseline of what animals are here right now and at the same time ask big evolutionary questions?
I bring ecosystem perspective. Joe brings a molecular bioinformatics perspective.
In that toolbox are UF's supercomputers crunching waves of data.
Today's biology is really powered by a technique called next generation sequencing, where we basically can take an animal and decode its whole genome. Every animal has a book. So when we get a genome, we basically are getting this book, but in tiny, tiny pieces, and we're trying to put it back together. So once we start processing this data, all of these cool discoveries that have really not been accessible start to become accessible.
One of the unique aspects of Whitney Lab is that we are so strong in molecular biology. I think that gives us a set of tools to explore biodiversity that other groups just don't have.
Mixing fieldwork and technology, our newest professors are finding discoveries about our world that can impact your world in a major way.